Social development has been in focus over the past decade in Saudi Arabia, with healthcare at the forefront. Here to speak about where the healthcare industry is headed is Mohammed Tamer from Tamer Group, a leading pharmaceutical organisation in the kingdom. Well, Mohammed, maybe you can start by telling me, how has healthcare developed in Saudi Arabia over the past few years?
It has been developed positively in terms of expanding new hospitals. The Ministry of Health is really working hard at expanding hospitals in a very quick period of time. They're also encouraging more hospitals for the private and the government sector. Today, the healthcare in Saudi Arabia is a challenge. The e-health is an issue. The hospitals are automated, but there is no interlink between them. So like everywhere else, infrastructure solution, IT solutions are challenges. And human capital or human workforce is a challenge to obtain for the growth to cope with the population.
How much is the healthcare industry worth, and how do you see it developing with government incentives?
They're building over 138 hospitals. They're reaching 44,000 beds. This is a ratio of 3.5 beds per 1,000 of the population. Currently, we're at one bed per 1,000. So it's quite a considerable increase. The total healthcare budget is expected for 2004 to close around $27.4 billion. If the expenditure continues the same, it will reach around $47 billion in the next 2 years.
Well, as a leading Saudi conglomerate, how is Tamer Group structured? And how involved are you in driving the country's healthcare sector forward?
My grandfather, Dr. Mohammadi, was a pharmacist and moved into Saudi Arabia in 1922, specifically Jeddah. At that time, he was the first pharmacist and opened the first pharmacy. Later on, my late father and my uncle decided to expand the pharmaceutical distribution network of the Tamer family business. And we have opened all over the kingdom and the GCC. Today, we are a company structured of three divisions: healthcare, which is a pharmaceutical and medical devices, that category, consumer, which is fast-moving products, beauty care, and hair colorants. And the third category is the prestige, perfumery, and luxury items. We are number one in the pharmaceutical in Saudi Arabia today, in value and in quantity. We bring the latest products that are available for the local market, and we also manufacture locally for the Saudi and the GCC, Levant area, and North Africa.
What are the health trends in the country, and how are you responding to these?
Well, the health trends, unfortunately, is the same most of developed countries, where you have the issue of NCD, non-communal diseases. This is, in Saudi Arabia, has become the society is affluent society, and unfortunately, obesity, lack of activity, has contributed to the increase of NCD, especially diabetes. Today, Saudi Arabia, about 25% of the population are diabetic. This trend is going on worldwide, but in Saudi Arabia, it is a major part, and everybody's tracking it. In addition, also heart disease. We are the number one importer of products that treat diabetics and heart diseases in Saudi Arabia. Also, in addition, the aging population, and that requires a specific treatment for elderly people.
You have a strong CSR program. How are you aiding the development of Saudi Arabia?
In 2011, we made a CSR department called SAED. SAED means an arm. So extending an arm's help to the society. We are contributing in different arm for art and culture, where we invite Saudi artists to come to London, the UK, and United States to represent their artists to get more exposure. We also have an arm for education and training, where we teach and educate Saudi women and men the vocational work that they need to join organizations. In addition, we are a member of Qadirun. Qadirun is a Ministry of Labor organization, non-profit organization, for recruiting and helping organizations to recruit disabled employees.
You're also dedicated to the empowerment of women. What initiatives do you have in place?
In Saudi Arabia, women is still at home because they are not allowed to drive and so on. But we have strengthened our human resources department to cater for the specific needs in hiring ladies in the offices, at work, and the operation. The issue today is that we have to meet what they need. For instance, in Saudi Arabia, women are not allowed to drive to work, so you need to give them a transportation allowance. We're trying to get them to be more independent, so we give them housing allowance, benefits that daycare for their children while they're at work. So their mind is free to be at work and working rather than being worried about their children. So yes, we have recruited many women over the past over 5 years in our organization. We will continue to do so and try to give them the best benefit that we will be the number one employer in Saudi Arabia for women and male Saudis.
And finally, what's your strategy for future growth?
More joint ventures, investment in our operation. However, we would like to also expand our manufacturing. And one of the strategies is to develop and improve our research and development in manufacturing pharmaceutical products. In addition to that, we are investing in our operations, facilities, and our IT solutions.
Mohammed, thank you.
Thank you very much.